Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum, dear students. Our today's lecture is about the Islamic concept of mental health. Islamic concept of mental health is nearness to God. Our Islam says that if we are closer to the Almighty, then we will be mentally healthy individuals. The person who fulfills his duty to God and fellow human beings is mentally healthy. The person who follow the ordinance of the Almighty and relates in a very good manner to all human beings is a mentally healthy individual. Mentally healthy person is one who maintains balance between his wishes and emotions, subordinates his freedom to reason, and exercises restraint and moderation. So these are the characteristics of a mentally healthy individual, that he has balance between his wishes and emotions. He can control his emotions if they are overpowering him. He subordinates his freedom to reason. He does not allow his free will to exercise his reason. Rather, reason predominates and exercises restraint and moderation. There is balance among his wishes, desires, emotions, balance in his life. Then these are the Muslim thinkers who gave their concept of mental health: Ibn Masqwai, Ibn Arabi, Zakaria Razi, Hazrat Mujaddad al-Afsani, Avicenna, Imam Ghazali, Shah Waliullah, and Maulana Ashraf Ali Thanvi. Now we will discuss them one by one. Ibn Masqwai, he mentioned that man is the combination of soul and body. If soul achieves dominance, man will remain mentally healthy, for the soul relates to reason. So he said that our body is the combination of soul and body, and there should be the dominance of soul in order for us to be mentally healthy individuals, because soul relates to what is right for us, what should we do, and it does not allow us to do those things which are forbidden in our religion. Then is Ibn Arabi. He believes that the culmination of mental health lies in the annihilation of human self in the divine self. Annihilation means denying. According to him, if we deny ourselves in front of the divine self, then we will be mentally healthy. This basically means that we deny our wishes, our desires, for the divine self, and accept what the divine self says us to do, then we are mentally healthy individuals. Zakaria Razi, according to him, emotional attachment to material things causes mental disorders. He is of the opinion that if we are very closely and emotionally attached to material things, to worldly things, then we will suffer from mental disorders. If individual really believes that world is temporary, all material things like parents are divine blessings and entrusted to us by God and are preordained to return to God in the end, then their loss does not cause much disorder. So he is of the opinion that we should have this belief that this world is temporary, it is not long lasting. And if we believe this thing, then we will not get disturbed by the loss of worldly and materialistic things, even like parents and siblings, because we have this faith that they are given to us by God and it is predetermined order that we all have to return to Almighty in the end. So these things will not cause much disorder if we have this strong faith. Hazrat Mujaddad al-Afsani, he was of the view that as long as individual acts in accordance with Quran and Hadith, he will remain mentally healthy. Observance of Sharia is the guarantee of mental and spiritual health. So as long as we remain in touch, we follow the paths and teachings of Quran and Hadith, then we will remain mentally healthy. And when we deviate from these teachings, then we suffer from mental disorders. Avicenna, He postulated that soul is separate from the body and relates to mind. So he was of the opinion that soul and body both are two separate things. And soul basically relates to mind. If the soul is resilient, the individual does not fall ill soon. Resilient means if the soul is strong, then individual will not suffer from mental disorders or mental illness. The people who have weak soul, they suffer from physical illnesses. So strong and weak soul is basically, it comes to us by how we are attached to Almighty or how we are attached to these worldly materialistic things. If we are more attached to worldly materialistic things, then our soul is weak and we will suffer from physical illnesses. And if we are attached to the Almighty, follow the teachings of Quran and Hadith, then our soul is resilient, it is strong, and we will not fall ill soon. Imam Ghazali, he believes that contentment of heart reflects mental health. Contentment means satisfaction. If your heart is in peace, if it is satisfied, then you will be mentally healthy. And how does this contentment comes from? It comes from repentance of sin. When we feel, when we come to know that we have committed a sin and we repent over that sin, then the contentment of heart is achieved. Human self can remain healthy only through repentance and contrition. Contrition is again strong type of repentance. When spiritual crushing, if we commit a crime. So, if committing a crime gives us a lot of disturbance, then it means that our soul is arrived and then our heart will remain contentment. So, in this way, next time we will not commit that crime. He hypothesized four powers in human personality. Power of knowledge, power of anger, power of sensuality and power of justice. Power of sensuality is power of your senses. So these are four powers and there should be balance among these powers. If there is proper balance, then we are mentally healthy individuals. Shah Waliullah, he divides human actions into two types. Voluntary actions, involuntary actions. You are very well familiar with what are the voluntary and involuntary actions. Voluntary actions are those actions that are under our conscious control. We perform those actions voluntarily, on our deliberate will. Involuntary actions are those actions which are not under conscious control. We have no control over them. So people who perform voluntary actions of their own volition and free will, such people have self-awareness and is a sign of mental health. Now, if we are performing voluntary actions, those actions that are under our conscious control, because of our volition, of our own choice and our own free will, then we are mentally healthy because we have self-awareness. But if we are performing voluntary actions, not because of our own choice, rather, we are forced to perform those actions. Then, it means that we lack self-awareness and it is not the sign of mental health. Maulana Ashraf Ali Thanvi, he is of the opinion that God, the universe and the man are parts of the same process. This whole universal processes, they are same and they all are related to one another. God, universe and human beings, they are all related to one another. Now, distance between them determines mental health. How far or how near we are from God, how far or near we are from this universe, how far or near we are from other people who are living with us in this world, it determines mental health. So, if we are very far from any one of these processes, then we will not be mentally healthy. And if we are very closer to them, then it shows mental health. Definitely, if we are closer to God, then we will definitely be closer to other human beings. Because closer to God means that obeying the orders of God. And it is one of the orders of the Almighty to relate in a very good manner, in a very kind-hearted manner with the other human beings, showing complete respect to them. So it means that these processes are very much closely interrelated. He called mental disorders as internal or spiritual disorders, that these are the disorders of our spirit. He said that man possesses three powers: power of reason, power of anger, and power of sex. And balance among these three powers is important for mental health. So if there is imbalance means that any one power is very dominant and the rest of the powers are very much suppressing, then that is imbalance. And imbalance is the sign of mental illness. You see, in all of the Islamic teachings, balance is very important. Balance in your emotions, anger, balance in your sensuous pleasure, all these things, balance is very much important. If there is balance, then we will be very much satisfied, contented, and mentally healthy individuals. So this was the Islamic concept about mental health. Hope so the teachings and the postulates of these philosophers are clear to you. Thank you.